Suddenly there came another burst of that acute fear which had intermittently seized me ever since I first saw the terrible valley and the nameless city under a cold moon. And despite my exhaustion, I found myself starting frantically to a sitting posture and gazing back along the black corridor toward the tunnels that rose to the outer world. My sensations were like those which had made me shun the nameless city at night, and were as inexplicable as they were poignant. In another moment, however, I received a still greater shock in the form of a definite sound, the first which had broken the utter silence of these tomb-like depths. It was a deep, low moaning, as of a distant throng of condemned spirits, and came from the direction in which I was staring. Its volume rapidly grew, till it soon reverberated rightfully through the low passage, and at the same time I became conscious of an increasing draught of old air, likewise flowing from the tunnels and the city above. The touch of this air seemed to restore my balance, for I instantly recalled the sudden gusts which had risen around the mouth of the abyss each sunset and sunrise, one of which had indeed revealed the hidden tunnels to me. I looked at my watch and saw that sunrise was near, so bracing myself to resist the gale that was sweeping down to its cavern home, as it had swept forth at evening, my fear again waned low, since a natural phenomenon tends to dispel broodings over the unknown. More and more madly poured the shrieking, moaning night wind into the gulf of the inner earth. I dropped prone again and clutched vainly at the floor for fear of being swept bodily through the open gate into the phosphorescent abyss. Such fury I had not expected, and as I grew aware of an actual slipping of my form toward the abyss, I was beset by a thousand new terrors of apprehension and imagination. The malignancy of the blast awakened incredible fancies. Once more I compared myself shudderingly to the only human image in that frightful corridor, the man who was torn to pieces by the nameless race. For in the fiendish clawing of the swirling currents, there seemed to abide a vindictive rage, all the stronger because it was largely impotent. I think I screamed frantically near the last. I was almost mad of the howling wind wraiths. I tried to crawl against the murderous, invisible torrent, but I could not even hold my own as I was pushed slowly and inexorably toward the unknown world. Finally, reason must have wholly snapped, for I fell babbling over and over that unexplainable couplet of the mad Arab Al-Hazred, who dreamed of the nameless city. That is not dead which can eternal lie, and with strange eons even death may die. Only the grim, brooding desert gods know what really took place. What indescribable struggles and scrambles in the dark I endured, or what Abaddon had guided back to life, where I must always remember and shiver in the night wind, till oblivion or worse claims me. Monstrous, unnatural, colossal was the thing, too far beyond all the ideas of man to be believed except in the silent, damnable small hours of the morning when one cannot sleep. I have said that the fury of the rushing blast was infernal, cacodemoniacal, and that its voices were hideous with the pent-up viciousness of desolate eternities. Presently these voices, while still chaotic before me, seemed to my beating brain to take articulate form behind me, and down there in the grave of unnumbered eon-dead antiquities, leagues below the dawn-lit world of men, I heard the ghastly cursing and snarling of strange-tongued fiends. Turning, I saw outlined against the luminous ether of the abyss what could not be seen against the dusk of the corridor. A nightmare horde of rushing devils, hate-distorted, grotesquely panoplied, half-transparent devils of a race no man might mistake, the crawling reptiles of the nameless city. And as the wind died away, I was plunged into the ghoul-pooled darkness of the earth's bowels, for behind the last of the creatures the great brazen door clanged shut with a deafening peal of metallic music whose reverberations swelled out to the distant world to hail the rising sun, as Memnon hails it from the banks of the Nile.